Hello my dear students, this is Pratap Sharma welcoming you all to my online English class. Today I will be dealing with a very common topic known as right form of verbs. We are very familiar with this topic. In order to understand this topic well, I will be talking about 8 structures regarding right form of verbs. Dear students, let's get started with the first one. The first one is as if or as though. In case of as if and as though, we have two kinds of structures. Look at an example. Example one, it sounds as if it dash a hammer. We have be verb in bracket. If we have, dear students, if we have present tense, I mean present indefinite or present perfect tense before as if, then we have to use past indefinite tense, mean past form of the verb, in the verb following as if. Then example number two, if we have past tense, let's pronounce the sentence, the boy behaved as though he dash met. Dear students, look at this example. If we have past form of the verb before as if or as though, then we will have to use past perfect form of the verb after as if. It means we will have to use had been. Dear students, let's look at the second rule. That is, if we have as well as, together with, along with, in addition to, etc. If we have these words or phrases in sentences, then we have to use the verb based on the first subject of that sentence. I mean the verb will, if we have as well as, together with, along with, in addition to in the sentences, in that case the verb will be determined by the first subject of the sentence. So we have he here. He as well as his brothers dash in bracket be verb present in the meeting yesterday. As we have he at the beginning, the verb will be followed by he. So he, as it is in the past tense, we will have to use was. The main thing is the verb will be followed by the first subject of the sentence. Then look at third rule, third structure. If we have either dot dot or neither dot dot nor, it means if we have either or neither nor in a sentence, then the verb will be determined the close subjects, the close subjects seated near the verb. Let's take an example. Neither you nor your friends dash responsible for this. In bracket we have be verb. So the closest subject of the verb is friends, and your friends is in the plural form. So the verb will be are.
If I clarify it more, if we have either or neither nor in sentences, then the verb will be followed by the nearest subject of the verb. Then look at the fourth structure. Fourth structure is very much interesting in case of uses. If we have used to or be used to or get used to, you can say get used to, be used to or get used to in any sentence, then verb will be determined by the structure. Let's see an example. He used to walk in the morning. Basically, we use used to talk about a habit in the past. Whereas we use be used to or get used to talk about something we are experiencing. Let's read out the example again. He used to walk in the morning. As we have used to, then we will have to use the present form of the verb. I mean after used to, not after be used to or get used to. If we have just used to, we use the base form of the verb. On the other hand, if we have be used to, here in the example we have he is used to walk in the morning. We have be used to, or it may be get used to. In case of be used to or get used to, we will have to use verb plus ing form. So you have to remember these things because students often get confused with this particular item, used to or be used to. Okay, dear students, let's have a look the next structure. If we have since in sentence, if we have since, we can deal it in two ways, or I can say since can be used, or since can be dealt with two ways. Let's utter the example first. Many years have been passed since we meet in bracket. If we have present perfect or present indefinite before the since, we know since related sentences has usually two parts. If we have present perfect or present indefinite before the since, then we will have to use past form of the verb. So it is meant, as we have present perfect before since, so we will have to use past form of the verb. Another example, many years passed since we dash again meet in bracket. We have past form of the verb before since. Many years passed. If we have past form of the verb before since, then we will have to use past perfect in after the since part. So we will have to use had meant. So these are the two ways we can deal with since. Next to the next rule. It is high time or high time. This is a very, this is a very important rule. We all know this particular expression or particular phrase can be done also in two ways. Take a look at first example. It is high time we quit smoking. Quit in bracket. We have a verb quit in bracket. If we have subject after the expression it is time or it is high time, if we have subject after the expression, then we will have to use past form of the verb. Quit. It is high time we quit smoking. Quit is a kind of verb which has the same, which has the same forms in three which has the form which form is the same in three parts. So quit, quit, quit. Let's see the next example. It is high time dash, it is high time dash quit smoking. So we don't have, in this particular sentence we don't have subject. So if we don't have subject, then we will have to use just 2 plus base form of the verb. 2 plus base form of the verb. So it is high time or it is time, this particular expression can be done in two ways. Let's have a look at the next rule. Had better, if we have had better, would rather, in case of right form of verbs, if we have had better, would rather, then we will have to use just base form of the verb. Look at example, he had better dash go home, go in bracket. So we have better expression, so we will have to use just base form of the verb. It means the form given in the bracket will remain the same. Let's look at the last structure. Though it is a last structure, it is also equally important. If we have unless, we all know unless is a kind of word which means if not or except if. Unless denotes negative meaning. So whenever we use unless, we have to use positive verb in the unless part. Let's see the example. Unless you are honest. After unless we have verb, we have subject, then we have a positive verb. We cannot use unless you are not honest, because unless, the word unless itself denotes negative meaning. Unless you are honest, you can, in bracket, success in life. You can succeed in life. So, as we have unless in the first part, we have to use cannot. We have to use cannot in the second part or negative in the second part. We cannot use, the thing is we cannot use double negative in English. So, we have unless you are honest, you cannot succeed in life. So, this is all about right form of verbs. I believe if you can understand these 8 structures, you will be able to do this item very well. Thank you all. See you very soon.